Everybody, it's Invicta, and it's the time you've been waiting for here. Hopefully, anyway, because Q's have been taking a long time. As Murky, we're going to finally try out the brand new reworked Murky. And I know that a lot of people have been generating buzz about it being too strong. I personally don't have a whole lot of experience with the new Murky. I've been purposely trying to put off any sort of serious gameplay with a build for Murky, just because I want to try to see exactly what kind of subtle nuances there are and the differences between the old version of my slime build and this one. So you may see a couple of Murky games this week. I haven't decided whether or not I'm just going to do a couple of chain Murky game recordings here during this session. But the first build that I want to try is it's very similar to the slime, the infinite slime build. Which I don't think I actually called it that, but anyway, it's a very similar slime build that I used to do on Murky. You saw it a couple days ago on Jesse's channel. You saw it on my build on my channel as well, even though I didn't link the build on there. But the new rework for Murky brings up a lot of pretty neat ideas, and particularly one called Toxic Buildup, which is a level, I want to say 16 talent. It's level 13 or 16. I think it's 16. Where every third basic attack Murky makes on a hero will do an automatic untalented slime cast, which means that you're able to refresh the slow. You're able to do more damage because it does the amount of damage, the base damage of slime whenever you do use it, your Q ability. And on top of that, Murky still gains a lot more uptime, and the more uptime you have, the more damage you're doing, etc., etc. The more times you're hitting the enemy hero, the more slimes you're causing because of toxic buildup. I think that's a really neat idea. One thing I will say is that there's a new quest talent. I don't remember what it's called, but it's fairly early on. I believe it's level 4, where you are instructed to slime heroes that are already slimed 15 times. And it seems, in principle, pretty darn easy, but in practice, it's actually kind of hard, especially if you're going up against a very mobile team or a very mobile hero like we are going up against right now with Lucio and Li Ming. Of course, additionally, we also have another Murky on the other end, which is going to make my job of landing the double slimes a little bit harder, but luckily, later on in the game, as it progresses, there's some other talents that you can get for Murky to sort of alleviate the time differences. Who is that? Oh, that's Brightwing. I was like, what the heck? Looks like someone like snuck in an old Warcraft 3 era sprite, and then I realized, no, it's just Monkey Brightwing. So on our team today, it's going to be Kel'Thas, Murky, Nazebo, Zarya, and Brightwing going up against Murky, Zul'jin, Mirrodin, Li Ming, and Lucio. Now, I know some people are going to be asking for more Lucio games. I know that I only did two of them. I did the first look, and I did the proper first look. And honestly, I'm kind of good with that. I like playing support. I think that everyone pretty much knows that. Lucio, even though we had a pretty good game there, we had a bad game and a good game. But Lucio's not really my cup of tea when it comes to supports. I don't like really. There's a couple things I don't really like with Lucio's playstyle, mainly being the fact that his heals are very healy over time. And I realize that this is ironic coming in from a Malfurion player, but still, I do feel that Lucio is good in his own right, but it's not my style. And honestly, support games to show here on the channel, especially with the way that Lucio's style is not particularly all that interesting. That was a lot of damage that Li Ming just did to me out of nowhere, by the way. I had no idea that she was there, so it's going to be very difficult to land against Li Ming, especially with all the changes that have happened here with the pufferfish. The fact that you can now hit the pufferfish with AoE. I do need to be careful. Level 1, by the way, I did take Fish Eye, which is going to increase the amount of sight radius on my egg, but more importantly, it gives Murky a movement speed bonus whenever I do resurrect. It gives you a 45% movement speed bonus, meaning that you're able to get back into the fight a lot sooner than normal. So if I do get some decent uptime here on Li Ming, I would be able to kill her. One thing that the biggest downside about Li Ming going up in this matchup is the fact that she does have a very, very low amount of HP. So if I'm able to land a couple of chain slimes on her, she could be in a lot of trouble. There you see you see how fast Murky's health regen is. And that's something that was looked at. He did get a little bit of a buff as far as his HP goes, but of course he did get a nerf when it came to his respawn time. Not exactly sure where Li Ming went, but I'm going to sit up here and be a nuisance on the top lane. Li Ming is actually in mid right now, so if they're going to let me have free reign up top, I'm going to go ahead and happily take it here. Another change that you're going to see is that you're going to see the towers actually start to target and fire after the pufferfish, which is not something that used to happen anytime, in the before time. I saw that galaxy coming in from a mile away. It's not my first day around the block here, Li Ming, if you know what I mean. I don't know what that means. Again, I want to try to do a little bit of glancing damage there with the pufferfish. If we get a lucky strike on Li Ming, that's super fine. Of course, I want to make sure that I have the safety bubble off of cooldown, because I want to make sure that if I do indeed need it, it's going to be there. And of course, I need to get in a good position to block a little bit of the damage there. I could probably save a little bit of damage on my creep as well. So level 4 was the level. Slime Time is the name of the quest. So what this one is, this one's, again, it seems simple in principle, but in practice it's actually kind of difficult because of the fact that you have to hit a slimed hero. And especially going up, like, say, against a Li Ming, for example, that means that you're going to have to land a, like, almost like a double slime. I was able to land one right there. No, actually, it didn't actually count. So I guess joke's on me. But again, you see there, I was able to dodge. As long as you're able to dodge the skill shots of Li Ming, it's really not all that bad. Whoa there, okay. They had 3 people in that bush. So you're going to see me spawn here. My egg is sort of out in the middle of the lane. Obviously, I want to stay stealth, or I want to keep that location hidden, easy for me to say, as much as possible. As long as possible here as well. Apparently that slime did not count towards slime time, which is actually unbelievable. Nice job by Zarya there, saving me a little bit with the particle barrier. The Zeebo's just not going to come up here. That's fine, too. Okay. I wasn't actually expecting the arcane blast right there. So I do need to be cautious right now, because obviously if I come out of the bush, they're going to easily spot where I am. But luckily, I do have safety bubble up, so if they do decide to come out this way, I will be able to jump on them. I'm pretty sure that that's pretty much exactly what I knew was going to happen there, was that as soon as I revealed that I was sitting in the bush, they're going to find the egg. So I have to wait now a solid 12 seconds for the cooldown here, 15 seconds, whatever it is. And obviously the enemy team can't see me, so they're going to be able to see exactly where I put down my next egg. Again, this team comp that we're going up against is a little bit sketchy for Murky, just because of the fact there's no real safe place for me to put down my egg, given the fact that they can just dive, they can dive any tower that they want to. So level 7, you're going to be going for Black Lagoon, which should help alleviate a little bit of the concerns about landing the Slime Time quest, which is something that, like I said, is very, very difficult to do. I did not expect Lucio to be in there, to be honest. So after 4 minutes, it's 5-0, which is good. I didn't realize we were down by so much. And have we... Let's see. No one's going after Murky down in the bot lane. It's probably a bad idea. It's not usually a good idea to leave Murky all by himself. And now Li Ming finds herself overextended here in a little bit of trouble. He saw there that I was able to land the slime, so I did finally get a little bit of credit for the first slime time. Ding there of the quest. Again, I'm going to use safety bubble to basically keep the gap open between me and Li Ming. And then I spam the slime and just see if I can keep her in here. Oh, Li Ming actually kind of goofed there. I almost got her. She almost screwed up that blink. If she had stayed around for basically a half second longer, she would have been dead. But we are still down by almost 2 levels, 6-0 right now. I don't know what we're doing, team, as far as XP is concerned, but this ain't it. This ain't the right way to do it. So I'm going to assume that Li Ming's probably not paying attention right now, and I'm going to try to... Excuse me. Thank you. I'm going to try to put down my egg just a little bit further. Again, because I took Fisheye, it is going to have a little bit of extra protection and be a little bit tougher to take down, but that doesn't mean that, of course, it's invincible by any means. So it looks like Nazebo may have lost the bot lane to Murky. And with the constant back and forth here with Li Ming has made it a little bit difficult for me to take over the top lane. But right now they've got all their attention focused down on the in the mid lane. So I'm going to see if I can help out and push the top lane just a little bit. Just to get some sort of push happening, because we're not pushing any other lane, that's for sure. I thought I got that safety bubble off, apparently not. Apparently I am mistaken about that. Gather tribute or face me. So obviously Li Ming knows that my egg is there. I'm gonna say that was probably just a lucky guess, because there's no way that anyone saw me. No one spotted me putting that egg over there. So we're gonna have to sit here and wait before I can actually get back in the lane. So after 7 minutes, it's 8-0, and we're trailing by 2 levels, which is always good. Definitely kicking off the week right with solo queue. We may have to do another makeup game here to get a better feel of Murky. and try to remove the solo key silliness of it from it all. I was able to get March of the Murlocs off, and somehow the Murlocs didn't jump on Li Ming. I don't know how that happened, because she was right in the middle of that cast. We'll see if I can bait out the Arcane Explosion, which is right there. I'm basically trying to dodge around Li Ming, because you know what's coming. If I can dodge the Galaxy, yeah, see, she's a little bit gun-shy, trying to go in on that. And even though the enemy team got the first curse, I'm gonna keep trying to do what I can up here up top. Let's even get Li Ming to get a little too cocky here. She did use her explosion. Almost got the slime off on her. You saw there, she's able to use abilities against the pufferfish, and that is one of the bigger weaknesses. Hey, we finally got a kill. We killed Lucio. It's there we go, 2-12 on the comeback trail team during their curse phase. It's good. We have not actually taken any fort. In fact, my lane is the only one that has a gate down, which is good. And we're still carrying the solo queue silliness here. We did have a 2-stack on our team, I believe, by the way. I don't remember which one of our teammate was, but it's all right. We're just going to keep doing our murky things as murky does up here. March the Murlocs back up off of cooldown. So Li Ming only really has her teleport for a defense, and that's it. So if I can catch her with March of the Murlocs, she's not going to be happy. There we go. And it did not cast in the way that I was facing. That's good. I just have to dodge one more, and then I should be able to catch up to her. Oh, the enemy team's Murky arrives. As well as the entire rest of the enemy team. That's good. All right. 14-3. Let's do it. We still have somebody less than 3,000 XP. That is something. At level 13, I'm going to be going for the rejuvenation bubble, or rejuvenating bubble, which is going to basically increase my health regen by about 50%. It heals Murky for about 50% of his maximum HP whenever he does use the safety bubble. Accidentally dismounted there because I'm trying to get to Azaria as fast as possible. I was able to land the slime there on Lucio, who got pushed back from the AoE there by Brightwing. You see how much HP there I am able to regenerate thanks to the rejuvenation bubble. Again, gotta be careful with my egg here. Obviously, I'm probably not gonna be able to keep it up very much longer. Li Ming just goes straight for the egg, and we're just gonna have to give up we're gonna have to give up our location for now. It's good. We're doing it, team. 10 minutes down, 17-3. We had a game like this with Lucio, and I guess we're just gonna have to another game with Murky. It's all right. We'll get a chance to do redemption here. If this game doesn't work, we'll do it tomorrow. Gather tribute in my favor. It's important to show off the finer things in life when it comes to solo key silliness. To show you all that the silliness really never went anywhere. It's always been here. If you venture into my land, welcome to my world, as it were, in the land of the solo queue. You need to know, if you're going into solo queue, you need to know and understand what you're getting yourself into. Most of the time, it's gonna usually be like this. The outliers are the ones where we actually get winning games. I actually get to do, like, you know, a build that's somewhat, not like, maybe not as perfectly planned as I'd like, but somewhat, you know, in the vicinity of where I wanted to be. The enemy team stole our boss, which is good. Unfortunately, I was not able to get up there with March of the Murlocs. Not exactly sure what Zarya wants me to do for him. You know what, I'm just going to sit here and try to harass the boss. Murky's going to try to hit me with Black Lagoon. Not going to happen, Murky. I'm pretty sure I got out of that one, Blizzard. Apparently not. The next tribute is going to be down bot, and obviously I cannot go that way because I will be exposed by the watchtower. So I do need to be a little bit more attentive when it comes to the map right now with the place of my egg. I'm just trying to put it in a somewhere non-obvious position. Zarya's having difficulties going up against Murky. I mean, we're down by 2 levels, so the stat difference might be a little bit of an issue. I was able to get the slime there, and apparently this Murky picked slimy pufferfish. Which, good on you, Murky. I like that talent. I also appreciate this Murky giving me a couple of easy pings there with my slime time quest. I got another one there as well. So we are going to be able to take down Murky. There we go. Good job, team. Now we have another boss mob to take down. It's good. That's all right. Never give up, never surrender in the land of solo queue. Where the people wear hats and the hats wear people. I do have March the Murlocs ready to go, so if we get a good flanking angle on here, that would pretty much wreck their world, especially given the fact that we have Zarya and Kael'thas. So there's Zarya. There's Kael'thas. And here comes the Gravitron Surge there by Zarya. And we got one, might get two. Nice polymorph by Brightwing. There we go. Triple kill. Lucio was taken down as well. Very good job by our team. So I might be able to catch up to Li Ming. Hello, Li Ming. Did you miss me? I bet you didn't. I missed you, though. There we go. Good job, team. We did it. So level 16, going to go for Toxic Buildup. And that is the one that I was talking about, which, of course, it is a level 16 talent because we just saw it. And basically, every third attack that I get against an enemy hero, not like minions, not anything like that, the enemy heroes, that's going to cause a slime burst. And what that will do is essentially slow them down, give them a little bit of extra burst damage in the power of the basic attacks of Murky. And on top of that, it's also going to help contribute to the slime time quest. Now, I should probably mention that this is a little bit of a weirder situation in this game because we are losing so badly that we have only 9 pings on the slime time quest. I'm usually done with the quest by around level 16 in the couple of games that I did play as Murky. That's the new Murky, I should say. There you go. So I'm relegated to cleaning up the bottom down here. And you know the enemy team's going to try to just push this one for a victory. As we have most of our team going after our second tribute. Make sure I'm not going to get sniped here by the catapult. So Murky goes down. I'm just going to keep on trying to push back the bot lane. Enemy team was able to get their own Sea Giant camp. I do know that there's a bribe build that you can do as Murky right now, which is very, very strong. I've never been a huge fan of bribe builds. I like doing more brawler builds with Murky, but we may try it out. The new bribe I hear is pretty darn good. So the enemy team is going to try to fight over here. There's Brightwing trying to do the Emerald Wind. We are able to get a couple kills. Living Bomb actually spreading on pretty much everybody, and down goes the enemy team again. They cannot afford to keep doing this. And Li Ming going to try to get away, but she's unfortunately going to run right into me and Zarya. And there's Taz Dingo by Zul'jin. The enemy team get wiped out again. Never give up, never surrender in solo queue silliness. There's March of the Murlocs here, and Murky's going to go down instantly. So, yeah, it's not over yet, team. If you didn't think that this one wasn't silly, I don't know what you're watching, because this one's very silly on multiple angles. They're now only down by 7 kills. Our team is doing a great job there, even without me being up there, because I was busy trying to take care of the bottom lane. And we actually get a tribute cap, with the boss spawning in 20 seconds. There we go, I was able to land the slime, and we slow him down enough to get Murky.
Killing spree.
So with 46 seconds left, I did see that Murky spawned up here, so his egg is going to be in this bush here. I know that that's the real one, so level 20 is where things get fun. You could go for never-ending Murlocs, but I'm going to go for Big Tuna Kahuna, which is basically going to double the amount of HP that Murky has, along with doubling the amount of respawn that it takes for Murky whenever he does get resurrected by the egg. But what's nice about this is, look at my HP. I actually have a lot of HP. Basically, I have the HP of like a small, like a more weaker Lunara, I guess. I'm a very squishy assassin, but now I can actually trade blows and get that so much coveted uptime that I've been needing. I'm still 5 stacks down on slime time. Murky going unchecked in our base. However, I am pushing the top lane all the way back. I'm gonna see if I can collapse down here to help out my team with a March of the Murlocs if I can. Apparently, Murder did not get hit by that. I'm not sure how that was possible. Taz Dingo there ticking on a Zul'jin. Sorry, I'm trying to get the hit out on Li Ming. We are able to take her down. I'm gonna get the slime here on Lucio. Was able to land the basic attack. Lucio still trying to get away from me. Not gonna happen. Down goes Lucio. I'm not gonna be able to get away from Murden, but we were able to kill two of them there. Murden gets polymorphed by Brightwing. Murky still going unchecked at our base, however. You see how long it takes for me to respawn because of Big Tuna Kahuna, whatever you want to call it. And Murky can actually end the game by himself if he goes unchecked. So I do know that he put his egg somewhere up here in the top lane. I'm actually going to see if I can take him down. There's Murky using the safety bubble. There's his egg right there. Murky using the slimy pufferfish there to land the slime. And unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to catch up to him. If I can only land a couple of basic attacks on Murky, that will pretty much be the end of it because of the fact that I've got the more HP. He's not going to be able to successfully brawl with me. So right now I'm going to turn my attention to the bot lane here. I still like the placement on my egg. It's not too far forward where it's dangerous, but it's also not far enough back to where I can't readily reinforce my team if we get in trouble. What was that? Did you see that catapult shot? What was that? That's not how physics work, Blizzard. Yes, Zarya. That is where you are. All right. We are done with Zarya. So despite us getting right back in this game, we're still going to try to defend this again. The damage of the first push that the enemy team did was almost unrecoverable from, but we have persevered. I'm going to sit here and brawl with the entire night camp. The enemy team was able to get their boss, which is the reason why I did not agree with going over here to get our own night's camp. It's a very obvious play there, but so we're going to have a boss on our core. And if that boss gets there, that's pretty much going to be it. Oh, a huge March of the Murlocs, though. Into a monster Graviton Surge. Down goes two of them. A counter March of the Murlocs by Murky. But we've got to go over here. And since we're cursed, we're not going to have any creep to stop the Golem. I think this is going to be the end of the game. So, unfortunately, the lead that we had at the beginning was not... Or the deficit that we had at the beginning was not recoverable from... We gave it our all, though, team, but you can't give up 14 unanswered kills at the very beginning. I did lose my egg, by the way. I'm not exactly sure how they spotted that. No, we're actually going to get a defense here. No, we're not. Because we got Sea Giants, that's it. So final total is going to be 21-17. Good try, team. But yeah, I'll leave this build down below. Let me know what you think about it. We did a lot of siege damage. Did not even finish up our slime time quest, but I think I could be forgiven in a game that was this silly and stupid. So thank you for watching. I'm enjoying it. As always, see y'all in the next episode. Till then, so long, everybody!